Forbes Africa het vroeër vanjaar al internationaal bekende Leading Women's Summit in KwaZulu-Natal gehou. Nou vir die eerste keer sal 'n soortgelyke beraad ook in Oos-Afrika gehou word. Die beraad bring meer as 250 sakeleiers by mekaar en vind eerskomende Vrydag plaas wat natuurlik Vrouedag in Suid-Afrika is. Ek gesels nou via Skype in Rwanda met Renuka Metal, redakteur van Forbes Africa, oor die betekenis van hierdie byeenkomst. Hallo Renuka.
Hi Bivan, how are you? Thank you for having me on your show.
Renuka, the purpose of Forbes Women Africa is to amplify stories of women. Why is this such an important undertaking to you?
The magazine is about 5.5 years old. The reason we have Forbes Women Africa is not just to profile tycoons, business tycoons. It is to profile women across from the formal economy to the informal economy. I think it is very important to tell those stories simply because they're not told enough. If you look at the mainstream publications, how many of them actually devote enough space to women entrepreneurship? And that is very important. I mean, if you look at the population, more than half the population in the world is female, and yet not enough is being written about their successes. And that's why Forbes Women Africa is important. We won several awards in the last 5.5 years, and we continue to do so. And one of the key ways in which we, as you mentioned, amplifying these stories is through events. So this is why such platforms, such events, and we also have a website now. It's very, very important.
Renuka, you're currently in Kigali. Tell us more about this meeting, which will be taking place on the 9th of August.
Yes, I am in Kigali. I've been here a week. It's one of my most favorite cities in the world. But that's not the only reason why we have the event here. So we've got the Forbes Women Africa Regional Forum happening on Friday at the Kigali Sabina Hotel. The reason we chose Kigali is because if you look at it, it even has a world record. 67% of the parliament is comprised of women. Now, this is a tiny country of 11 million people, but yet this is a huge that's a landmark figure for any government in the world. And so women play a very key role in the economy here. If you look everywhere, you know, if you look at from security guards to business owners to women in the cabinet, you know, everybody, women have a very key role. And that's also because of the government's stand on gender-related, gender-friendly policies. So what better setting than Kigali to have an inaugural regional forum event for Forbes Women Africa? Now, I'll tell you a little more about this event itself. It is a satellite event, a mini version of the flagship Leading Women's Summit we have every year. For the last 4 years, we've had a very successful run of that event. This year in Durban, because of the KwaZulu-Natal province of South Africa, we had Leading Women's Summit. This is the fourth year. Next year is the fifth milestone year. But if you look at this year, I mean, on the 8th of March on International Women's Day, the Leading Women's Summit was attended by 800 women. Sure. And we had so much power packed in that room. It was headlined, the keynote speaker was Naomi Campbell, who flew in all the way from the US. And we had a host of ministers from across Africa, A-list speaker, so it was so phenomenal, and now we're taking it forward. We will definitely take the flagship event forward every year. Next year, as I said, it'll be on the 8th of March, as we always do, but this is the regional forum, and this is the first time we have in the regional forum, and we chose Kigali specifically.
Renuka, at the Forbes Leading Women Summit, you speak of the power of the collective. What do you mean by this?
Okay, so the power of the collective. Now, let me just go back to an example from earlier today. So all of today I spent in the remote districts of Rwanda, far from the city center of Kigali. I was actually profiling female basket weavers of Rwanda. So I spoke to a number of them, and you could see all of them huddled together in cooperatives, in groups, sitting under a tree, sitting in a small factory, weaving, making these baskets. And some of these baskets even reach the Macy's department store in the U.S. So here is a collective, you know, the women sitting together, they come together, they forget their hardships, they forget their financial problems. They come together, they weave these baskets and they put together. There's that sense of community. And that is really is the power of the collective. And that's a very small example. So when you similarly have 800 women from across Africa coming together in a room, think of the power of that collective. Think of the power of the community you're building. And it just does not stop with a summit in a ballroom. I mean, these stories are amplified further on social media, and you're creating more communities of like-minded individuals who need to come together to further reiterate the fact that, you know, unified, if we stand, we will create more success. We will be better role models for the next generation.
Ranuka, you guys are doing fascinating work, and thank you so much for that.